This is the answer from the server. That means, boom, that's correct. Those 3 and 6, 8 is responding. But if I lay down and I play dead and I stay dead, maybe you'll get sick of being the monster out of my head, under my bed. Hey, welcome to Rifki the Cyber. If you want to do the penetration testing towards to the network that contain to the diameter, for example, the diameter prone to expose, in this case, we just need to have Nmap and of course the script to running the diameter to checking whether this is really diameter or not. This is what I'm going to show it to you now, guys. Rather than a lot of theory again, let's check together, guys. Right now, what we're gonna do, we need to go to the GitHub in this case. We just need to download the code first. This is in the my GitHub, RFKII diameter CR. Later, I'm going to share the link inside of the description of this video. But of course, guys, there are some terms of conditions, like for example, how many count of view that I would like to achieve from this video. Please help to share, click subscribe to this video to others. So when this is achieved, I will just open the link itself. Then you can check time by time towards to this link descriptions, of course, on this video in this case. Now what we're gonna do, let's download the code. It's simply like this, download the zip. Okay, this is already download. After we download this, we just simply unzip this one and we just need to open this. In the diameter CR here, you can find there are two scripts here. First server, second CR only. And this is the dictionary diameter from the Wireshark format. And this is the library diameter that used in the Python. The prerequisite is you are using the Python 2. Later, so what I'm gonna do. So after this, what I'm gonna do, I'm going to open my terminal. And then we just go to the where the directory exists in this case. And then go to the desktop. I'm going to open the other one, of course. So I'm going to put here. So inside of this script, there are two scripts here. First is for the server, simply like this. When the script of the Python is switched on, then it will be listened in the port 3868 in this case. And this is the other script that I'm going to explain it to you. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to running this. So after this, we just switch on the server itself. So it's simply script like this, Python 2, just to make sure go to server in this case. Now the server is already listened in this case. Now, for example, if we would like to do the Nmap, we would like to scan the port, for example, it's very easy in this case. If the diameter is running, first you need to check in the SCTP first. Maybe the diameter is running in the SCTP. How to check? You can check in my video here in the cards. So yes, Nmap for the SCTP, doesn't matter guys, if this is running in the SIGTRAN or diameter, the SCTP is the same. If example the diameter is running on top of the SCTP, you still can use this way to check using the Nmap itself. But if you want to know how to do it with the TCP/IP, well, that is a common way to do it. So in this case, right now my script is using a TCP/IP because I already showed it to you how to Nmap scan using the SCTP in the video in the card that I already showed to you in the preview minutes before. You don't need to know what is the port of the diameter. So what you're gonna do is you just simply do the nmap like this, sudo nmap dash p dash. I'm going to make a stealth mode. That's why I'm using the sudo, because the stealth mode require you the sudo, because it tweak the lower level of the TCP/IP when they are sending sync and then forget without waiting the SEK. And then after that, my own port, and then I'm just going to grab the diameter. I don't care others. Okay guys, it turned out from here, after the result from the Nmap, the diameter of port is open. Now, we can check what is the kind of the diameter that is open by using another second script in this case. So what I'm gonna do, I'm going to open my Wireshark, and then after that, I'm going to go to loopback, and I'm going to running my second script. Aha, we already have. So this is capability extend request. It's built here because the 3868 is open. So this is my script. My script trigger the origin host, Rifki the Cyber, my realm.rifki. Don't forget to subscribe, like and share and give the comment, and also my realm.rifki in this case. So I'm pretending to be in the PCRF in this case. I'm pretending to be the PCEF. So next is, there are some answer from here, and this is the answer from the server. That means boom, that's correct. Those 3868 is responding with the diameter capability exchange answer, and this is diameter success. That means the server is saying, hey, I'm a PCRF in this case. Now, not only the using the Nmap is using my script Python here, we can make sure that this is a really diameter server, because it's responding using the capability exchange request and then responded again with the capability exchange answer. If you want to know, capability exchange request is written here very clear. Capability exchange request, yeah, this is the diameter code, and this is capability exchange answer. You can see also from here, capability exchange, yeah, this is in the request side, yeah. This is origin host, this is my origin realm, the originating came from which box, yeah. And this is of course some supported vendor ID, normally 10415 is a 3GPP standard vendor, for example. And this is the answer, hey, I also capable for the this one, for the 3GPP, and my node is a, by the way, my node is a GX or the PCRF, policy, control, and role function in this case, or policy, yeah, something like that. So, and after that, my client sending, okay, I would like to pretending this is a normal box, okay, I'm going to send it to you, diameter device watchdog, and then it's answer, okay, success, this is like a keep alive in the diameter. And then the rest, because I don't want to look it obvious in the traffic, I'm going to disconnect gracefully using the standard, because if not gracefully, then what will happen is it will be trigger the alarm, and the alarm will check, hey, there are some disconnection not normal between peer-to-peer diameter, and I would like to know came from which box. So I make sure I make my script in this case is gracefully shut down, comply with the with the RFC 3588 or RFC 6733. So this is a diameter a disconnect peer request. Okay, I want to disconnect. I just give another reason, do not want to talk to you. And then after that, it giving the answer. Okay, success. You can release in this example. So what the bad actor can do if the diameter is exposed in this case? Just watch my next video and you will see what can be possibility for the exploitation using the diameter. Please note everything for the educational purpose. So to avoid this kind of situations will be happen. The conclusion in this case is the network operator, of course, they need to whitelisting what will be the origin host, origin realm that need to trigger, of course, on top of the firewall in this case. The whitelisting of the origin host is really necessary in this case. And of course, the network operator need to check whether this IP is somehow detected in the IP crawling website. And if this is turned out, is reflected there and can be accessed from there, they need to make it close from the world in this case to make it really exclusive in the network. So that is my advice how to avoid that one. Like my other video, keep learning and stay humble.